در طول 5 دهه گذشته شما فعالیت‌های مختلفی کردید برای احیای حقوق سرخپوستان در آمریکا، از اشغال مسلحانه چند منطقه در آمریکا تا بازی در فیلم‌هایی همچون آخرین موهاکان و همچنین کارتون خیلی معروف پوکاهانتس. از اون زمان تا حالا فکر می‌کنید که این فعالیت‌ها باعث شده که سرخپوستان آمریکا صداشون بلندتر بشه و همچنین حقوق بیشتری به دست بیارن؟
I am an American Indian patriot. We live in a prisoner of war camp. That's why they call it a reservation. Everything the military, the U.S. military occupies is called a reservation. That's why the soldiers, when they left their camp in Iraq, they would say, we're going to the reservation. That's the mindset. They're still playing cowboys and Indians, the military of the United States. Nothing more than retarded children. At any rate, with my activism as an American Indian patriot, sometimes it had to be militant. It was always in self-defense. But I fought against the capitalists, the United States of America, armed struggle, and I fought against the communists. I fought against the Sandinistas with the Indian people of Nicaragua, okay? I go up and down this hemisphere looking for a nation of Indian people who want to be free. And guess what I found? It's my people. Who want to be free.
شما کودکی خودتون رو بسیار عذاب‌آور توصیف کردید. گفتید که پدرتون به الکل اعتیاد داشته و مادرتون همچنین به مواد مخدر اعتیاد داشته و همچنین جرایم مختلفی انجام داده. آیا فکر می‌کنید حالا در دنیای امروز بچه‌های بومیان آمریکا وضعیتی بهتر از کودکی دوران شما داشتند؟
Oh no. The native children's life is worse. That's why we have to be free. My mother and father were forced into boarding school. Their hair was cut. And they had to put on uniforms and march in with everyone else all the time. They were physically punished and sexually taken advantage of. I know my mother was. I didn't find that out until after she died. But the traumatic experience of over 80 years, almost a century, of what they call boarding schools. Tens of thousands of children were starved to death and diseased to death by these boarding schools who disappeared. My job, until we're free, will never be over. And that's what we are in the process of approaching the Inter-American Commission on Human Rights to validate our treaties as international documents. Then we're going to be sponsored by a country in this hemisphere to the World Court. The United States is not part of the World Court because it's an outlaw country. It always has been an outlaw country. It's evil to its own people. And they don't see it. It's pathetic.
در یکی از سخنرانیاتون شما گفتید که بومیان آمریکایی که در محل‌های تحت کنترل خودشون زندگی می‌کنند به عنوان شهروند آمریکایی شناخته نمی‌شند. منظورتون از این جمله چی هستش و آیا واقعاً همچین اتفاقی در مرحله حقوقی بین یک سرخپوست و یک شهروند آمریکایی اتفاق می‌افته؟
We're prisoners of war. Legally, that's what we're. They won't tell you that. But in order for them to continually violate their constitution and their treaties with us, we have to be prisoners of war. Okay? So the whole idea of what Guantanamo and Bagram comes from Indian reservations, just like the Nazi, what Hitler called the labor camps. That he wrote, the United States of America has a great idea. Apartheid in South Africa, that came here. The West Bank, The whole strategy of the Israelis comes from America.
شما وضعیت بومیان آمریکا در مناطقی که تحت کنترل خودشون هستش رو مقایسه کردید با وضعیت فلسطینی ها در نوار غزه. منبع مقایسه شما در رابطه با این دو وضعیت چی هستش؟
Well, it's very easy when you understand the methodology of the United States of America. And like I've always said, we are the Palestinians of America, and the Palestinians are the American Indians of the Middle East. Okay? We suffer from the same strategy.
درسته که شما مقایسه میکنید وضعیت مردم خودتون رو با بسیاری از مردم دیگه در جاهای دنیا، ولی من در نقاط مختلفی در خاورمیانه بودم و بسیاری از مردم اون مناطق آرزو میکنند که برای داشتن زندگی بهتری به آمریکا بیاند. آیا شما فکر نمیکنید که وضعیت شما در آمریکا کمی بهتر از اون مردم هستش؟
America has no culture. That's why it's greedy. That's why it's by itself. That's why it's hated. It has no culture. Everyone that comes here comes for one reason, greed. It's the only reason they come in, and they leave everything behind. Everything. Their land, their culture, their family, their relations. It's pathetic.
شما در جایی گفتید که مردم آمریکا تفکر انتقادی خودشون از دست دادن و به شکل شگفت‌انگیزی هر چی که دولتشون میگه باور میکنند. آیا واقعا به همچین چیزی معتقدید؟
Listen, everyone in the international community that has the least bit of sophistication, the American people are a joke, a bad joke. Just to go back a few years, 12 years, to the year 2000 when Bush was selected, he wasn't elected, you know? There you go, right there. Everybody just laughed at the United States. If some other country had done what they did, they'd call it a coup and they'd march in their Marines.
شما از دولت باراک اوباما رئیس جمهوری آمریکا به شدت انتقاد کردین و گفتین که به حقوق بومیان آمریکا توجهی نمیکنه. اما آقای اوباما تقریبا در همه جای دنیا فعالیت میکنه و ادعا داره که دولت کشورش داره تلاش میکنه حقوق بشر رو در سراسر دنیا گسترش بده. چطور به این نتیجه گیری رسیدید؟
You know, we have a word in our language for the United States of America, and it stems from an ancient belief of the ichthyomi, someone that lives backwards. Yeah, that's the ichthyomi is our devil. We call him the ichthyomi because he's a trickster. He's not evil. He likes to trick you and to make mistakes in life. Well, the United States is a devil. Obama receives the Nobel Peace Prize, and his whole speech is about justifying war. His acceptance speech. I mean, hello? The world can see Obama for what he is.
شما موقعی که وندد نی رو اشغال کردید در سخنرانی گفتید که ما اینجا رو اشغال میکنیم که ارتش آمریکا بیاد یا ما رو بکشه یا اینکه دولت به حرف ما گوش بده. آیا فکر میکنید که از اون اشغال که حدود 40 سال پیش بودش تا الان دولت آمریکا بیشتر به صدای بومیان آمریکا گوش میده؟
It's only gotten worse. We have no voice. We are a people out of sight, out of mind. Okay? Only when we stand up for ourselves do people begin to hear and listen. Now, I know the history of the white man. I know his from his very beginnings when he was put in Europe. Okay? And I know how he built this country, his America. It's an insidious, evil country based on death, all for corporate greed.
دلیلتون برای این حرف چیه؟
The facts are American history. The United States of America is the only country in the history of the world that's been at war every year of its existence. Okay, every year of its existence, 136 years. Every year. It's been at war. Sometimes multiple wars.
شما در وبسایتتون این منطقه یعنی لاکوتا در ایالت داکوتای جنوبی رو به نام جمهوری لاکوتا نامیدید. این جمهوری چه مشخصاتی داره؟
Well, the Republic of Lakota, there's the provisional government that I head. We are promising our people nothing. Our people have been promised everything by Christian missionaries. They've been promised everything by government agents. They've been promised everything by everyone that wants to make money off of our backs. And we get nothing. So when we withdrew from our treaties with the United States, we said we're not going to promise our people anything. We're going to do. We're going to be an example. And also we want to convince white people who want to be free and might want to move here, because there's white people here. We tell them, you have to rule by consensus. You cannot protect individual rights with the majority, because there's always a minority. You have to rule by consensus. Now you can do it small, or you can do it large, but as long as it's by consensus.
بزرگترین مشکلی که بومیان آمریکا در قرن 21 با اون مواجه هستند چیه؟
Oh, we face death. We have the lowest life expectancy on earth. On earth, man. We're worse off than Haiti, health-wise and poverty-wise. Our men only live to 43.9 years. Now, if you take out AIDS, take AIDS out, and all the other sicknesses, only 8 countries have shorter lifespan, and those are all in Africa. So that's how bad off we are, and in Canada. I mean, they feed us filth. That's all we get to eat. I don't know, you've been on this reservation. We have one grocery store for 1,500 square miles, or about 1,200 hectares.
آیا این مشکلات از سمت دولت آمریکا؟
Listen, we're not allowed to run our lives. The Bureau of Indian Affairs of the United States government runs our land and runs our lives. Only 22 families control our land. You know, the 1,100 hectares. Just 22 families. The rest of us are poor. Those 22 families are mostly white people.
شما وارد دهه هفتم زندگیتون شدین و این به نوعی در فرهنگ سرخپوستا یعنی بزرگ قوم شدند. برنامه‌های آینده‌تون به عنوان یک بزرگ قوم سرخپوست چی هستش؟
What I want to do is save our language with the young. We're trying to establish Lakota only schools, no English allowed. Because as you know, and that everyone that knows another language, the English language is very primitive. It's, you cannot adequately translate any language into English because it's so primitive. What I have to say to people all over the world is, because I live in the belly of the monster, you have to stay home. You have to improve your world until it's in balance. And I don't understand, I do not understand any religion that condones violence. I just don't understand that. And I know the patriarchal world loves violence. The United States is the perfect example.
Thank you so much, Mr. Thank you so much, Dr.